I love that you are wearing the draft day suit, the red and white on Jalen Rose. Today is the day that changes people's lives, changes the future of franchises. And as all of these prospects are being evaluated, their games are being picked apart, what they do on and off the court is picked apart, people look for something. They look for positive attributes, and they also look for red flags. So Jalen Rose, I'm going to give you some details about these prospects and ask you the question, is this a red flag?
You're gonna ask the dude that wore a red and white suit,
yes,
is something else a red flag,
exactly,
on another individual?
If I was about to draft you in 1994 and I saw the suit you were wearing, I would be like, that's a red flag,
okay.
I'm not drafting.
So that's how we play this
game. So you understand how this works now. Perfect. Our colleagues are reporting that there's a potential that Michael Porter Jr. could redshirt his first year in the NBA. Jalen Rose, if you are evaluating these prospects, would you consider that a red flag?
No.
No, explain.
Because he was the number one player coming out of high school just a handful of months ago,
mm-hmm,
amongst all of these prospects.
Yep.
He only played 3 games, 53 total minutes.
Yep.
He had back surgery. During workouts, he dealt with a hip issue. And so,
small hip issue.
I understand that people will say, you're already picking in the lottery, so you can't afford to make a move like this. But that's what Philly did with Joel Embiid.
I know, I kind of like the redshirt professional NBA player. Ben Simmons worked great for him. Blake Griffin worked great for him.
And a lot of teams that's picking at the top of the draft will be in this
good
position
point.
Again.
Not trying to win a championship next year, yes.
So for him, he's that level of talent that I would his upside outweighs that risk, so I would not wave the red flag. I would still take him as an elite prospect.
Great. Next, Mo Bamba refused to give his medicals to the Grizzlies and said, basically, I don't want to play for the Grizzlies. Would you consider that a red flag if you're a GM that was going to draft Mo Bamba?
If I was the Memphis Grizzlies, to me, that's a slap in the face to them. And it doubles down and shows you why keeping the tanking goes wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not gonna give him the red flag. I'm gonna give it to them because they gotta create an attractive organization that says, okay, they're getting Marc Gasol back. They're gonna get Mike Conley back. I wanna be a part of that. But these young players saw the product they had on the floor last year, and a lot of them probably say, I don't wanna be affiliated with that organization. JB Bickerstaff. If the name sounds familiar, because his father, Bernie, is a longtime coach and
yep,
NBA executive. He was the person, unlike you, that drafted me wearing this suit.
I would never draft you if you were wearing that suit. So DeAndre Ayton looks like a great prospect. You know, seems like he's going to be an all-star. Seems like he's going to make an impact. Seems like he's certainly going to be picked number one in the draft this evening, but you never know. However, we don't know what he's like off the court. But we have read that he has alter egos, one of which is named Alejandro, who sort of speaks with a Latin flair. The other is named Josh, who's a middle-aged yuppie. Jalen Rose, DeAndre Ayton having alter egos, is that a red flag if you're looking to draft?
It's something I'll pay attention to, but for me, it just sounds like he probably has a couple of fetishes that he may grow
right
out of.
That's Alejandro and Josh right there.
And all young people have things that they stop doing once they mature.
Mm-hmm.
But also, we all become someone else. Like Beyonce becomes Sasha Fierce.
She did for a while there too, yeah.
You know, so I gotta allow him to cook and see how productive he is out on the floor.
Great Sasha Fierce reference. Really showing your range here. Next, Luka Doncic told Howard Beck of Bleacher Report some of his goals for when he moves to America, some of the things he wants to accomplish. In addition to an NBA championship, he wants to date Jennifer Aniston, dunk on Porzingis, buy a tiger like Mike Tyson, buy a Porsche, a McLaren, and a Lamborghini, and win a championship. Jalen Rose is already waving the red flag.
Because he's doing too much.
That's a lot. That's a lot.
He ain't even walked across the stage yet, okay? I wasn't even feeling like that, okay?
You just wanted to fix your teeth.
I just wanted to fix my teeth and have a pool filled with 40 ounces. That's all I wanted.
That's a red flag too, though. Let's be honest.
Correct. And buy my mother a house. Those are the only three things I wanted to do.
Before you get a Tiger, Luka, before you get a Tiger, let's average like 10 points and 8 assists. Let's do that.
And you don't just holler at Jennifer Aniston.
No.
No.
No, yeah,
she's
you don't.
Out of your league.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll say it for her. Okay? So she doesn't have to.
Next. This one is interesting. It's brand new. Marvin Bagley, a lot of attention on him today in the past few months. He dropped a mixtape. You are going to draft a prospect that just dropped a mixtape. Is that a red flag, Jalen Rose?
It's 2018, and it can't be. These young people love music, and the ability to make music on their phones or on their computers is so available to them. It's not like when we were growing up, it's like, oh, I need to go to the studio and I need to be there 12 hours.
Good point. Yeah, you don't have to invest too much time and money the way technology is today to have a mixtape.
You have off time. We're all watching TV or listening to music anyway.
Here's the thing. We listen to the mixtape or a little snippet of it, not so bad. It would be a red flag if it was terrible. If it's a terrible mixtape, is it a red flag?
It would be a red flag, two things. If the content was over the top, which it isn't.
Good point.
And or if it was whack.